Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Hey, what's going on, guys? I'm back. I don't know what happened. We had an issue. It's technology. I'm not, unmuted. Yep. Not totally familiar with what's going on. But like I told you guys, we have a very big show today. We have amazing guests, people that have been well-rooted in the dog world for decades, I would say, I'm sure. Let's get right into this interview. I had a lot of talk beforehand, so let me just jump right into this interview and invite the guest in.
Uh-oh, there we are.
There y'all go. How's
it going? Okay, okay.
Get both you guys in the shot for me.
I'm trying now. Leave it alone.
All right, folks, who you're looking at right now is Lori and Gypsy of Rock of Ages Kennels.
Hey
guys, how's it going?
How are y'all?
I'm good. How are you guys doing?
I'm good. I'm still trying to get in the middle of this frame.
Okay.
Wait a minute. That's better. Leave it there. Okay, how about that?
That looks pretty good.
Good.
So how are you guys doing today?
Oh, real good. How about you?
I'm doing excellent. So I was telling the folks, let me actually bring myself back into this conversation.
Go ahead.
Let me do this real quick.
Good.
There we go. Perfect. You know what? This is just two of you guys. I'm going to take myself out. I'm going to just let you guys be on.
No. We like looking at you with that big W on your hat.
That's right. That's for the city I come from, Washington, D.C.
Uh-oh.
Yes, sir.
Is that Chocolate City?
It was.
Yes.
It's getting to be a little bit more mocha right now. It's less chocolate.
All right. Well, nothing wrong with that.
Nothing wrong with it at all. Hey, that's but right. Listen, please, obviously, I've done my research, but I want to be, I want you guys to provide all the answers because I believe that you are the two people with all the answers, especially when it comes to the Canis Panther.
Yes.
First of all, introduce yourselves individually. Talk about what it is that you do together and separately.
Okay, I'm Gypsy, a master dog trainer, 50 years at least. I started training professionally in 73, 74 under Earl Jones, the greatest personal protection dog trainer that I've ever been aware of. His philosophy was defense. He meant, when he said personal protection, he meant personal protection. He didn't mean sport. He didn't mean entertainment. He meant personal protection.
Right.
That's where I learned. Like I said, since 73, 74. So that's who I am. And here's the star of the show, my wife. Go ahead, babe.
Hi, everybody. I'm Lori, owner of Rock of Ages Kennel.
Yay!
Home of the Canis Panther.
All right.
Listen, for real, I've been blessed with dogs all my life. I love dogs, any dogs, big dogs, small dogs. Yeah. But my heart has always been to a mean dog, a protection dog, a watchdog. My favorite sound in the world is a growl. Nothing better than a good, deep belly growl.
That's right.
Love it.
Nice. So tell me this. So with that in mind, tell me exactly what is it about the Canis Panther that makes it such a wonderful guard dog? Well, first of all, tell me what is a Canis Panther?
Yes, that guard dog is not what a Canis Panther is.
Okay.
Canis Panther is a pet protector.
Okay.
He is primarily the sweetest thing, sweetest pie.
Sweetest
to who he lives with.
Smartest.
Right. Now, people he don't live with, he is going to be asking for your identification.
And does not want to be bothered with you.
Yeah, he's going to be rude, but he's going to be sweet to everybody you live with.
Okay.
Loves your family. It don't matter if you, mom, the baby, or a turtle.
Yeah.
He will love who he grows up with.
That's right. That's their personality.
And not care about anybody else.
That's their basic personality.
Okay. So when did the Canis Panther come into existence?
70s, probably late 70s, as far as a breed standard is concerned. So, just something came into, a lot of times people have the misconception of a a mixed breed dog. Well, the Canis Panther is a blended dog. It's a blended breed because it's not just happenstance. Oh boy, that guy's got a German Shepherd. I got a pit bull. Let's breed them together. That's a mixed breed dog.
Right.
I'm trying to get this camera shot right here. So
right there.
That's good.
Perfect,
yeah.
Right there.
So, I would say late 70s for breed standard. And of course, Scorpio Jones, Lucas Lopez, and myself are the founders of the breed. Scorpio and Lucas are not with us anymore.
Okay.
Rest in peace. But Scorpio was, he's one in a million as far as a human man. He was very persuasive, very powerful, driven. And Lucas was a sweetheart who loved and trusted Scorp. Scorp really relied on him, and I'm so glad he did, because Lucas is who, in my opinion, or not opinion, everybody got opinion. I have an estimation based on being there, based on information, based on reality. Lucas gets my nod for holding on to the breed. Scorp was an impetuous person. He was like, I think I like that. Let's do that. And he would do it. Well, Lucas is the person that would hold his, you know, hold every, you know, he would hold Scorp back. No, Scorp, we got something good here. I'm going to hold on. Scorp would say, man, okay, you hold on to that, and I'm going to do this. And he'd always come back to Lucas. Scorp was the power. Lucas was the glue. That's what I think.
Okay. And, yes. And what were you in that equation?
I was the trainer.
Okay.
I was the estimator. I made the scientific determinations. My dad used to have a saying, looking good, acting right. So we all know what looked good. Lucas know what looked good. Scorp would know what looked good. But I'm the one to give the tests. So I know who's the quickest. I know who moves the fastest. I know who has got the longest win. I know who has the brain. I know who's too mean. I know who's mean enough. Why? Because of training. Yes.
Okay.
And Scorpio was very, very smart man. So when I say, hey, Scorp, this one right here, not that one over there. In most cases, he listened. Yeah, in most cases he listened because he was handling the dogs, and he was right there too. It's not like we weren't doing it together.
Right.
He was handling. Scorp is one of the greatest handlers ever because I never got hurt in front of the Scorp's dogs because he was such a great handler. I could get close. I mean, I could get inches. I could get where I could feel the breath on my neck. I could, you know. So Scorp, man, it's impossible to even categorize Scorp because of he was a man mountain. He was, wow. He was one of the most dynamic human beings I've ever known. Am I just rambling on here?
No, I appreciate all that information. I appreciate that. All right. And that's good. That's the kind of background that we, that I'm sure that people, the fans of the breed would love to hear.
Right.
So when you say the breed is blended, do you mind sharing the breeds that were blended?
It's been published. It's Dane Dobe Lab and staff. And back in those days, you know, somebody tell you have a staff, he looked like a staff, he might have a little pit bull in him. So that is the closest to reality. Nobody's ever tried to hide that. Nobody's ever tried to change that.
Right.
Well, there are people now. Yeah, there are people now who, you know, they only have one dog or maybe they have two dogs and they want to act like they want to improve things so they might change it. There are people putting Dogos in them now and and other types of Mastiffs. What's that dog called?
Or so.
No, it's a name, that guy. I forget his name. Anyway, so people are trying whatever they want to try. Here we go now to the superstar, Lori, who is the breeder. I am not a breeder. I've never been a breeder.
Right.
I'm a tester. I'm a tester, an evaluator. Lori is a tester, evaluator, but more importantly, She is the breeder.
The breeder, okay.
That's
so,
right.
So
who have maintained this breed.
Right.
Go ahead.
So Lori.
Right, go ahead. Sorry? Go ahead.
No. So being the breeder, tell me what is the character of the breed? What makes a Canis Panther characteristically? What is that?
Characteristically, how would I say that? I want to say the.
What type of characteristics
we'll
are you speaking
about?
Temperament,
of? Emotional, mental. Temperament.
Oh, temperament. Temperament. Okay.
The heart and soul of the dog.
Go ahead, tell them.
The heart and soul of the dog, they have a wonderful temperament.
Mm-hmm.
Very easy, mild. They're a very sensitive animal.
Yeah.
It's an animal that loves love.
Mm-hmm. It's a pet.
It loves to love you.
It's a damn
he
pet.
He adores you.
Ain't no soldier.
Looks up to you. Wants to be around you all the time.
Right.
And smart enough. That's what draws me to the dog. Because, you know, there's nothing better than a smart dog.
You're right.
I love an intelligent animal. And they are one of the most smartest dogs I've dealt with. And I've dealt with a lot of dogs. As a professional dog trainer, I've been training dogs over 20 years. In therapy, in obedience, working and handling and personal protection. So I get to see and evaluate all types of dogs, sizes, and know what I have in the Canis Panther.
Right.
When I first met Scorpio in the 90s, I was actually going there to see a Rottweiler of his.
Grenade?
Grenade.
Yeah.
I was going there.
Hey, do I need to close that door? Them damn dogs making too much noise.
Oh, don't worry about it. I think we're good. I hear you.
Okay.
Was going to see a Rottweiler of his, and he took me in his backyard, which I heard later was a very rare thing to do for a Scorp to actually take someone in his yard. He took me in his yard, and he showed me around, and Grenade the Rottweiler was the biggest thing I ever seen. He was probably 180 pounds.
Bad boy, too.
And his head was the size of a truck tire.
Yeah,
I couldn't take my eyes off him, but there was some other dogs in the back that kept jumping up and trying to get my attention. And I turned over there and I'm like, what's that? And they're like, oh, that's a Canis Panther. I'm like, what? And I went and stood in front of this dog who just stood in front of me, staring at me, looking at me, jumping around, jumping up and down, looking at me. And that was Gator, I believe.
Yep, that was Gator.
That was Gator. Who ended up being my dog's father, the first dog I got from Gypsy and Scorpio.
Mm-hmm.
But they said, okay, you want to see another Canis Panther? And they took me out the backyard and down the alley. And there was
this
sense.
Inglewood now.
We're in Inglewood now. Okay, south side. And they took me down the alley to this property that had a fence about 12 feet high. And they said, just stand there for a minute. And it was real quiet. And they're standing behind me. They go, touch the fence, Lori. Touch the fence. So I reach out to touch the fence, barely touch the fence. And all of a sudden, this dog comes flying down about 100 stairs, running at me, running. Gets up to the fence, pounding on the fence, looking at me like this with his mouth wide open. They're like, that's Shaquille.
Yeah, Shaquille.
I'm like, oh, my God. Shaquille was the Canis Panther. The baddest dog I ever seen. I stood there and I swear my first word was, I gotta have one of them.
Shaquille. That's how you better talk to him.
He was something else.
Wow. Go ahead, mate.
So tell me, what is the size of a Canis Panther? Height and weight. Is there standardized yet?
Yeah, it's in our book also, The Owner's Guide to Raising a Pet Protectors, the standard, the colors, all of that. But yes,
standard came around. It was, I don't know, late 90s or early 2000 that Scorpio and Lucas Lopez came over to our house here at Rock of Ages Kennel.
Yep, yep.
We sat down in the dining room.
Yep.
Scorpio and Lucas opened all their books to us and told us, this is what I want you to do. This is how we're going to raise the dogs. Now let's create the standard and let's find a kennel club for these dogs.
That's right.
That's what he asked me to do.
Yep.
We sat there that day. We put the standard in place. The dogs are you know, approximately 28 inches high. They can go, males go from a good 125 to 140.
Yep.
Females average about 100 pounds.
Yep.
Some are a little bigger, 115, 120.
You know how you feed them. Feed them like a church lady. Yeah.
Right. And that was the standard that we look for.
Right.
Okay.
And what we try to do. Now, Scorp and Luke, you know, he told you before about Lucas and Scorpio, the different dogs that they had and chose. So we had dogs from Scorpio. We had dogs from Lucas. And later on in the years, we got dogs again from Scorpio and dogs from Lucas.
Yep. And we also got a very lesser known name. I'm going to give you the scoop. His name is Sterling. He had a line of Scorpio's dogs. And we also got some of Sterling's dogs. Now,
right.
That's a scoop, brother. No one knows that other than who knows that.
Well, thanks for sharing, because now everyone on the stream knows that. You guys should be privileged to know that.
Okay.
All right, cool.
He was like a secret weapon for Scorpio.
Yeah, he was one of Scorpio's secret operatives.
Okay, cool. So, Gypsy, you had mentioned, is there colors that are standard for the breed as well?
Yeah, black, dark chocolate, buckskin, and blue. Occasionally, okay. You will get a pattern, like a Doberman. Occasionally,
okay. No brindles.
But that doesn't. No
brindle
ever,
at all.
Never, okay. ever. No.
Coats are solid. They could
solid.
Have.
Yeah, if they got a pattern or what we call a mingle hair, sometimes like a blue will have a grayish pattern.
Buckskin.
Or and sometimes you get what Lori calls a dirty buckskin, and they have a pattern. But no, never a brindle. Never.
Mostly all solid coat, small white blaze, a typical on their chest.
And there's some other beauty marks that we hold secret that we look for out of every generation or everyone that has one. We look for certain things that come from the original line. Yeah.
Okay. Tom asks, you guys have is your book available anywhere?
Yes, tell them.
It is. You can find it on Amazon, or you can go right to our website, which is easier.
Yeah.
At rockofageskennel.info.
Go to our website.
And the book, just scroll down, you'll be able to see the book, An Owner's Guide to Raising Your Pet Protector, $20, autographed, and shipping is free.
Absolutely. And we have a adult coloring book. Yes,
we have a Canis Panther coloring book.
Yeah, man.
Which
is really cool. My wife is a beast.
We got an artist who took the original photographs and turned them into art. So that's pretty neat.
That's right.
Beautiful. So let me ask you this. In terms of as a pet owner, someone who wants to own a Canis Panther, obviously, this probably not a dog for first-time dog owners, right?
Yes.
They can be.
Absolutely. Sure. Especially if you listen to us.
Because
we don't just give you a dog and wave bye-bye. We want you to be successful. So we're here. And we tell people all the time, call us. Don't wait. If you have an issue, a problem, a question, call. We're going to solve it. We're going to tell you what you need to know. But first, we're going to tell you, which is the truth, this is the greatest pet protector you have ever had.
Okay.
That is who they are. They are pets. They are not war dogs. They are not sport dogs. They're not police dogs. They are made for the family.
Right.
Made for the church lady.
Made on the southeast side of Chicago.
South side.
Down in Inglewood.
Right. Yeah, a lot of church ladies in Inglewood. There was a whole lot of
families needed to depend on the dog.
That's right. It was a whole lot of bad things happening around in the community. So the church lady needed a dog that would love her, love them babies, love whoever lived there, but was a demon to them folks walking up and down to and fro. You understand what I'm saying, brother?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So let me ask you this.
And it had to be smart and
smart, that's right, and loving. But serious,
right.
Serious, no trespassing sign. Go ahead.
So what are the exercise requirements and what activities are good if you have this dog as a pet protector? What do you want to do with this dog to keep it happy and give
feed
it a full life?
Pet it, feed it, pet it, kiss it, If you're smart, you do some OB. You always want to do OB with a dog, small or large, but definitely a large dog. You want to do some obedience. Mm-hmm. Yes, that's good. But the rest of it is good boy, good girl. Come here, let me hug you.
It's a very versatile dog.
Yeah.
It'll do anything you want it to do.
Sure. It's going to do good OB.
When you get it home at 8 weeks old and you mold it to
what
you
want.
That's what
you got to do. Don't go get one 2-3 years old, please.
Okay.
You can, you know, they could be a jogging partner for you.
Oh, yes.
Okay. They can be
You can sit
a
down
swimmer.
At the river and eat the French cheese and drink French wine and with your Canis Panther. And I don't care who it is. They're not going to bother
you. Not going to sneak up on you.
You're not going to be stuck up on. That's for real.
They like to, you know, play. They like to do whatever you want to do. If you're out there, they're entertaining.
They don't need no treadmills. They don't need to run the track every day. Those muscles they have are genetically passed down to them. They are extremely good-looking dogs. A lot of muscle. Athletic enough that they exercise themselves, but they're couch potatoes, man. If you sit on the couch and you allow them, they're gonna be right there
right
eating
there
popcorn
with you.
With you.
Okay, I mean, I'm looking at the dog. I would have thought that they at some point needed to burn off energy. They just look so fit and athletic.
That's genetics.
Genetics.
You
it
know,
is.
Yeah, you know, it's some guys, man. They don't do nothing, and they look like they just came from the gym.
That's true.
Right.
That's right.
Very true. That's what's up.
Okay, Gypsy, what I'm going to do is I'm going to someone asked to see what the dogs look like. You know, I downloaded a little video of Hennessy.
Am I going to be able to see the video?
Yeah. If you want to tell him anything about the dog while the video plays, feel free. Play the video.
Go ahead.
Okay.
The dog is in the house in a crate while you're gone. You come home, you take them out, you play with them for a while. And of course, if you go anywhere hiking or swimming, you know, they want to go with you.
Right.
Yeah, they love being with you now.
And again, they're solid temperament that you can take them places.
You can take them places, but I always tell people, Judge Judy, you don't want Judge Judy in your video. So teach your dog to wear a muzzle. When you're going out. We have a lady, a friend, actually, of the family. He's got a Canis Panther. Have walked in Times Square with her dog. But in the video where she's walking in Times Square, she says, a shout out to Gypsy. You see, he's in his muzzle, Gypsy, because she knew I'd be screaming and hollering.
Right.
Yeah. You're supposed to protect the public.
Right, of course.
You don't want Judge Judy in your video. If you know you got a mean dog, do the precaution that you need. So that everything goes well. You can't see me. You don't gamble with what you can't replace.
Right.
You don't guinea pig people. You don't use people without their permission as an experiment to socialize your animal. That's what I believe.
Right.
All the I'm sorry's in the world don't solve nothing. Yeah.
And if
you want to socialize your dog, feel free. This is America. You can socialize your animal. I don't socialize my animals. I socialize my animals with who live here.
Right.
You don't know who will be your friend next year.
Yeah, who your friend this year, man, may not be your friend next year. You know that?
That's true.
Yeah.
I understand
folks
that.
You have at your house, folks you have to your house might come in your house. Did you know that?
Of course.
Okay, so I don't put it on my dog to make those calculations and them determinations.
Right.
It's a line. Don't cross the line. If you want to come to Gypsy House, call. Don't walk up and open my door. You know that. Anybody know that? If you don't, my dog gonna let you know that before you touch the door. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, and you'll sleep very good at night when you have Canis.
That's right. You're going to sleep because ain't nobody, you're never going to wake up and somebody standing over you if you got a Canis Panther. Believe that. That's not going to happen.
Do these dogs bark much, or are they like silent? Do they move silently?
They are couch potatoes.
They're not a nuisance barker.
Yeah, they're not no nuisance barker. They're not hyper driven and all that.
Right, right, right.
When they hear something, they are the greatest, best protector there is, because they're not going to ignore something going on.
Right.
They hear something or see something, they're going to let you know about it.
Okay. And they started at a young age.
Oh, yeah. Four months old, man. They're going to talk to
someone
people.
Falls in okay. the
they're
going
to talk to you. They're going to show you. No, you're not going to steal them. I bet you that.
Right.
Because they're not coming.
They're not going to let you put your hands on them.
Yeah. No, I have a pit bull mix who doesn't bark at anything. I have a Rottweiler that barks at everything. And I appreciate the Rottweilers barking.
Yeah. You know, well, part of what that brings me. That but, brings me to, if there's any trainers out there, I did want to give again on your air a nugget, a little slice of wisdom, that alarm, challenge, threat display is what defense is all about. The alarm, challenge, threat display, engagement. Engagement is the last thing
right.
in that series of events. And that has been going on since the dinosaurs. Alarm, challenge, threat display. And if you don't believe fat meat greasy, you get burnt.
Okay. Well, just go into more detail about that concept, just because, you know, I understand the words in the series, but I think, you know, some people might be, might do better with a more detailed.
Okay, I'll give you an example.
Yep.
I'll give you an example. When sometimes, you know, especially guys, real cocky. Man, I got that 357, or I got that Glock, I got that AK. I ain't worried about that. I say, okay, but can your AK wake you up? No. I say, right. Can the AK point itself to show you where this guy is?
Right.
No. Right. Can the AK fly to your hand? It's in the closet. It's under the bed. Can you put your hand in there and say, AK, and will it fly through the air to your hand? No.
Right.
That's right.
No.
So that boils it down
right
there. That's what alarm does. That's why a dog is so superior to other weapons. A dog, a good dog, lets you know you need your weapon. Gives you time. Lori says, we're losing light because we're out on the front porch. But my words are still coming clear. If you need your weapon, it's going to give you time. And if it's got smart enough, if it is smart enough, it's going to help you to where it doesn't just sacrifice itself out there at the gate. So I encourage people that want a dog that's going to love them and protect them. Canis Panther is the best thing going. And all dogs from Rock of Ages Kennel are going to do this because that's our standard.
Right.
All of them. Everything we got. Min Pins, German Shepherds, the Cuties, everything we got is going to give you some layer of defense and security. Yes. Now, if you want to put more octane in it, you get some training.
Right.
Come and see a trainer. But don't go to somebody going to teach your dog to be a police dog. Don't go to somebody who's going to teach your dog to pursue and bite, because that's not protection.
Right.
That ain't defense.
Okay, so that brings up a good point, and that brings up something that, and this might be a little off track, but one of the biggest things, you know, when I did a protection dog video,
mm-hmm.
And I forget, I didn't put the Belgian, I believe the Belgian Malinois was on there, but he was rather low. The breed was rather low. And people kind of got at me about that. And that was part of my, what you're saying was part of my equation, is that, I mean, Belgian Malinois, I think, are great police dogs.
They are.
In terms of protection, I think they fall short, you know. One, the size, I think the intelligence, speed, and all that stuff that the Belgian Malinois is known for isn't necessarily something that I really need in terms of a protection animal.
That's apprehension. See, I believe prevention is superior to apprehension.
Right.
If your dog is working, nobody's got to chase nobody.
Right.
Right? Because if you got a real defensive dog, he's going to change minds.
Right.
So we don't need to chase nobody after the deed is done. If you got a real dog, he's going to prevent the deed. He's going to help you. He's going to change minds, man. Don't nobody want to get ate up. Bad guys do not want to be discovered.
Right.
They want to do it quick, get in, get out without being discovered, and they most certainly do not want to get hurt in the process of their crime. That's most bad guys, because they're cowards. It's most bad guys.
I'm starting to lose you a little bit,
Gypsy. That's right. Okay.
You guys are breaking up on me.
You still hear us?
Yeah, I'm here, but you guys are breaking up on me. I'm starting to lose. Your screen's getting weaker.
I see the screen. Right. The screen is frozen. We can see that. So what you want to do?
You're back. Listen. I know we could talk for hours, and I know we want to talk. You wanted to talk about
rules
and defensive protocol. Let's push that to another show because I think we got a lot of information. Probably each of those topics can be their own show. But I know a lot of people watching would love to talk to you. So let me open it up for people to call in and maybe ask you two or three questions. All right.
Okay.
All right. Great.
Go ahead.
So guys. Let's be quick about it. If you guys are watching this video, in the description, there's a link. You can call into the show, and you can have the wonderful honor of talking to the couple right now that's probably the most responsible for the existence and continuation of the Canis Panther. Now, I know a lot of you guys asked for this video. I'm looking at your comments. A lot of you guys are interested. You have a lot of questions. So now's your time. You can come in right now, ask the questions. I just clicked the link in the description, and you guys will get right in. All right, cool. All right, you guys have a porch light or something?
I'm gonna go see if it'll help. Hold on. Go ahead, ask your question. Yeah. Oh, sorry.
So, Lori, someone just asked in the thing, do the dogs do any scent work? There you go.
They have. You know, there's some that have done some. Of those nose classes with them, they have an excellent nose. Believe me, if I would have had the if I would have had the time to do another set of training, I would have gone through some scent classes with the dog. They have an excellent nose.
Okay.
And they can pick up one lady had called me and told me, you're not going to believe this. My dog kept smelling my eye up in my face. Mm-hmm. Bothering me, and I finally figured out I had an eye infection. I went to the doctor. I had an eye infection. The dog knew beforehand, before I even did.
Wow.
So the nose can pick up a lot of things.
Yeah.
Right.
And they're inquisitive. They're inquisitive. So, right. Yes. If that was a hobby of yours or something that you were interested in, yes, they could do it.
Okay, perfect. Lori, I know that you do therapy work. You don't recommend these dogs therapy work, do you?
Nope.
I don't recommend them for therapy. Hold on there. Because again, the dog wasn't made for that. The dog was made to be a home protector.
That's right.
And yes, I have one that is my therapy dog. She was born around the time that my bestie was real ill and passed away. And I coddled her and cuddled her and loved this dog. And I never told her she had to do anything but stay by me.
Right.
So she's so sweet. Her a personal therapy dog to me.
Yeah. All right.
But I would not take one into a facility to visit a person.
And this particular dog she's talking about, she may could. But
yes,
you don't gamble what you can't replace, man. You don't get any big people. There's plenty of dogs with the perfect personalities and temperament to be therapy dogs. Why push a round square peg into a round hole? You don't need to do that. It's a whole lot of dogs for that.
I totally understand. I have that conversation with people all the time. There was a guy that tried to call, and his name was James. James, if you want to call back in, just call back in.
I'm sorry, talking so long. Yeah,
no, that's okay. It's okay. It's perfect. This show's about you guys, so let's all information you guys want to share, I'm sure they're appreciating. I know I appreciate it. So,
okay,
talk, brother.
Talk. We appreciate being here, for real.
Yeah. So I definitely feel I know we had talked maybe back in 2019 about me coming out there. Here we go. Let's see. This is James. Let's get James on real quick.
Okay. Hi, James.
James, how's it going?
Hello?
Yes, sir. You can take your mask off, I think, right? Hey. I don't know where you are, but.
Yeah, you ain't on my voice.
So I just had a quick question.
Go ahead.
When someone wants a dog from you guys, what do you look for in that the buyer?
Good question.
Well, I'll have a few straightforward questions for them and have conversations involved with people for so long. You know, in case anyone doesn't know, my first half of my adult career was in the nursing field. So I've dealt with all kinds of people, and I feel I'm a good judge of character.
She'll turn you down, is what she said. She'll tell you, no, you're not. Yeah, we, because a lot of times, you know, people call and they'll be hot dogs, you know, tough guys.
Right.
And we can tell. We've been around a long time.
I will know from conversations with you
if
you're going to be a pet owner for a Canis Panther or not.
Yeah.
So have you turned a lot of people down, like, who want dogs from you?
Yeah, if they make me mad, I turn them down. That's for real.
People have been turned down, yes.
If they want to debate with me and all that and tell me about my dogs, I turn them down. I tell them, hey, man, you need to go get you another dog. This is a rare breed. We like it that way. So go ahead on.
Yeah.
Yeah. I definitely have. Especially if they want to debate with me about my dogs.
Yeah, so you kind of get a sense of, like, who the person is. You can kind of tell who, like...
Yeah, because I talk. You can tell I talk. You can tell I talk. So I'm gonna, you're gonna talk, and you're gonna reveal yourself, and there it is. Like, nope, you're not the right guy. See ya. I ask people, especially, my favorite person in the whole dog world, in the whole world probably, is the church lady. So I ask people, I say, well, do you have a family? Is it safe in your area? Are you really feeling worried about things? Somebody gonna be getting out of jail soon that you don't want to see. I'm saying, man, do you got a boyfriend that you could tell is getting ready to turn into a real jerk? I ask them kind of questions. When I get the answers, then I give them my honest assessment. Yeah, this is the one you need right here. Right. Yeah.
All right, and well, also, that was my question. Thank you guys so much.
All right, thanks a lot, James.
All right, James.
Bye, James.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
All right.
Hope we didn't turn you down.
Hope I didn't mess that up.
Don't worry about it. He'll be all right. I think I recognize James. James is he calls a lot. He's a good guy.
He seems to be a nice guy.
He's a nice guy, yeah. What about dog aggression with this breed? Is that an issue?
If it don't live with them. It's an issue. They got alligator aggression, bald eagle aggression, rattlesnake aggression. They aggressive towards whatever don't live in their house.
Right.
They're not crazy, though. They're not going to start any problems. They're not pit bulls. They're not going to sit back.
Yeah, they're not drivey. I got to go get that dog. No. If the dog live with them, if you look at that that slash show Lori showed you, it's some dogs that... Two Canis Panthers in the same shot.
I used to take Ruby, who to this day is the most decorated Canis Panther.
Yes.
We've done many shows. Yeah. We won trophies. Yes. We won ribbons.
Bad.
We did a lot of protection tournaments all over states, that were close enough for me to get to. And I would take her into my obedience classes.
Right.
In the park district where I'd have 10, 15, 20 students, and I'd set Ruby in the middle of the field, sit, stay, and make my class work around her.
Yep.
And she would stay the whole time. People would be like, oh my God, is she going to move? No, she's told to stay.
I'd be working dogs in personal protection. Dogs are in an aggressive, highly aggressive state. I would tell Chief down and stay. I wouldn't tie him to anything.
Mm-hmm.
And Chief, man, even if the dogs were coming at me, Chief had enough sense to know, man, this is what Dad does. And he told me to stay. I'm going to stay, and I'm telling you the truth.
Right, and a really good story at the vet. Chief had to go to the vet one time, and he had to have an x-ray, and of course I have to leave the room, so I told them, they're like, is he going to be okay? I'm like, yeah, he's going to be fine. Chief down and stay. He laid on the table. I left the room. They came back in about 10 minutes. They're, oh my God, Lord, he's still laying on the table.
Such
a wonderful animal when they're trained and they listen.
That's right. And when they're trained, you don't have to force them in. You don't got to put no spike collars on. You don't got to put no electric collars on. You ain't got to smack them around. That's right. You ain't got to smack them. You don't got to be General Patton. No. Good boy. Good girl. Just no, those are the three words right there. No. No means stop doing what you're doing right now. If you say it the right way at the right time, dogs, our dogs, understand.
Right.
That's for real. Right. And then, good boy or good girl. Go ahead.
Okay. So one of the things we love to do, my audience loves to do, is we love to compare breeds. So how does this dog breed compare against, let's say, like a Rottweiler, which happens to be my favorite breed?
Uh-oh.
Well, so Rottweiler has been my favorite breeds too.
They don't make them mad. I've trained some great Rots in my day, and we've had some great Rots. Mm-hmm. Mick Moman is one of the most outstanding boys. He used to babysit our other puppies, man.
Mm-hmm.
He was mad, and this Mick Moman was no joke. His name was Mick Moman. He wasn't no joke. But he was smart. He was sweet. His mother was Rosie. And Rosie was another smart, sweet Rottweiler that I traveled with and demoed with. So, as far as a comparison is concerned, this is how I do it. That's just how I do it. What kind of dog you got? Church lady say, I got a Rott. Okay, Rott is pretty good. Let's work him. Let's train him. What you want him to do? That's how I approach it. Because a dog is a dog.
Right.
I don't care if it come from the shelter. I don't care if it was born in a garage in an alley, and you picked it up, and all the rest of his litter mates died, and his mama's out there eating out the garbage. If you take it home, you feed it, you love it, you train it. That's the best dog. That's what I say. Go ahead.
But obviously, I mean, well, you said 120 pounds to 140 pounds. That's roughly the same size as a Rottweiler. So, I mean, so in terms of its bite and its stopping power, is it equivalent to a Rottweiler?
Oh, yeah, man. It's equal to any dog, man. Any dog as far as the destructive potential that it can wreak on a human body.
Okay.
Yeah. Human body is made out of tissue paper.
I have to go back to the intelligence.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I think I would compare that to any breed, as we have German Shepherds also, and the Canis Panther learns quicker than the German Shepherd.
Well, yeah, that's true, but my Shepherds are good.
Yeah. Yeah. I go with the intelligence. That, to me, that's the
they smart.
The level
they are.
Of
she's
the
right.
Panther.
She's
they
right.
Are very
that's,
smart.
That's one thing they if have a lot of breeds. To be honest with you, there's a lot of big head breeds, and I guess the Rottweiler is one of them. Is they sometimes a one track man. And they get stuck on stuff. A lot of times people say that means they are, stubborn or hard-headed. That's the trait of big-head dogs. They got so much room for their brain to rattle around in and their giant craniums that they are a little bit, they get stuck sometimes.
Right.
But if you work with a dog, man, and you love a dog, and you work with that dog, I don't care what breed it is. If it'll protect you, if it tells you the bad guy is there, here he is over here, and if he growls, show some teeth at the bad guy, maybe come at him, slow him down, man, that's the best dog in the world. I don't care what breed it is. Now, that's the truth.
Right. Right. Well, I love that.
Yeah.
I'll tell you right now, I just got a Rottweiler, my first purebred dog. Mm-hmm. He's 2 years old.
Mm-hmm.
And
yeah.
No protection training whatsoever, but
yeah.
yesterday. The other day, I was very proud of him. He just turned two yesterday.
Okay, happy birthday.
Yeah, 2 weeks ago, for the very first time, yeah, I walk him around the neighborhood all the time, but for the very first time, we were walking. It was nighttime. I typically don't walk him at night. And a cable guy came out of the house, and my dog, you know, started barking at him. He just did for whatever reason. He didn't recognize him, and he barked at him. And I kept walking because I didn't want any issue. But my dog turned around. He went behind me.
Did you tell him good boy?
Oh, I did. I told him, man, I'm apologize to you for letting my dog scare you, but I'm gonna let my dog up for this moment because this is what I need him to do. You know, and I told him, man, I said, don't worry about it. I'm not gonna let him go, but I am gonna congratulate him, and I'm gonna tell him thank you because he's always protected the house. Anytime around the house, he would bark, and he would, anytime he heard any strange noise around the house, he would do that since very young, since maybe three, 4 months. But he never really barked at people on the street, and that was the first time
that he did that.
And I told him, like, listen, this is a moment I'm gonna celebrate it. It's nothing against you, buddy. Nothing against you, but I'm gonna celebrate this.
That's right. Yeah. That's right.
All right.
Every bit of protection your dog gives you, you should reward him. I say always pay the dog. And I'm not talking about giving him a treat. I'm talking about good boy, my man.
Yeah.
Like that. Yeah. Or good girl. That's good. See, you hear my bitches go off when I say good girl. I had my head to say was good girl, man. They go for it.
That's right. Well, listen, that's right. I'm gonna give the guys, if you guys are out there, you want to call in, you got maybe two or three more minutes. I don't want to hold you guys up too much longer. In the description, there is a question. I mean, there's a link you can hit, and you can call in and ask your question. A lot of you guys are in the comments section asking questions that have already been answered. So if you haven't, I will say that it was mentioned earlier that the dogs are about 28 inches tall, 120 to 140 pounds for males, about 100 pounds for females. And then are they good with other dogs? We just answered. I just asked that, and the answer was if they're raised with them in a family, they should be okay.
So honestly, that's right.
I never leave any two intact. If a dog is intact, I never, and he's a, you know, like my rock.
Yes, never gamble with what you can, you can't replace. Right. That's the rule.
Right. So if you're going to have two dogs.
This ain't no Disney movie. That's what I tell people all the time. Hey, this is not a Disney movie.
Right. Exactly.
So, yeah.
All right. Very cool. Well, listen, we do have two more show ideas thanks to Mr. Gypsy. He's going to go over the golden rules. And he's going to also tell us about defensive protocol. How many golden rules are there?
13.
Okay, 13. I know that's a whole show.
Okay.
I was going to try to squeeze them in, but I said, no, that's a whole show.
Okay, bud. All right. Good.
Well, listen, guys, I want to thank you guys so much for coming on and spending time with me. I am going to... I'm going to come see you if you guys, Lori, we talked a while ago, you invited me, you said it was cool, and then, like, you know, 2020 really happened. I just, travel was shut down for me, and I didn't follow up, so I'm going to reach back out to you, and I would love to come visit you guys. And
you can come visit. We'll have a wonderful time. We'll drink a little bit and eat a little bit, but I will tell you that with the same thing I tell everybody, I don't care if they are the police, I don't care if they are celebrity, this is not the zoo.
Right.
And so I will show you some dogs and answer any of your questions, but this is not the zoo. That's just the way I am. That's a pet peeve of mine. I got it from Scorp. You heard Lori say, Scorp very rarely invited somebody back in his yard.
Right.
And I was special.
Yeah, she was special. That's why I married her.
There it is.
Yeah, but yeah, you're welcome, man. Okay, you are welcome.
Thank you so much. Yeah. I appreciate
bring that dog. I tell you what, when you come, bring that dog. Now let's get busy.
That's a whole other ticket. Dog. I don't know. That's a whole other ticket.
Bring that. Yeah, you'll be glad you did. You'll be glad you did. That'll be another show for you
there.
Yeah, bring that dog.
All right, guys. Well, thanks again so much. I really appreciate both of you. I love your spirit. I love your energy.
Thank you, Ezekiel.
You guys have amazing dogs. I watch a lot of your videos. You guys do amazing work, and I can see that that you guys have a community of customers and family and friends around the dogs, which I love that as well. I think that
we love our people.
We keep in touch with all the good people
that we love, and from one end of the world to the other.
That's right.
We call them. We talk to them. All times China, of the day, 24 hours Russia. A day.
That's right, man. We ain't been playing all the time.
We talk to people.
We ain't been playing around.
From families to high society.
We want you to be successful. Call us. Email my wife, but call us. We will talk to you, especially if you have our dog. Yep. If you ain't got our dog, we'll talk to you, but for not as for long.
Exactly. I get it.
All right,
guys. Well, thanks again so much. You guys have a wonderful evening. All right.
Thank you.
I'll reach out to you guys shortly.
Stay safe, everybody.
Stay safe.
All right. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Peace. Come on. Peace out.
All right, guys. There you go. Sorry for the technical issues that I had at the start of the show. Hopefully, everybody that was in the first stream made it to the second stream. I think you guys know that, this was a good interview, right? I see someone says great interview. I would say definitely good to great interview. I appreciate them. I appreciate the, generosity, right? They shared everything. They opened up everything. They gave us information. They gave us extra information. I'm definitely going to take them up on the opportunity to come out there and film their dogs and make a documentary. I know that's something that I think, whether you guys want it or not, I think that's something that I want to do. All right, so I'm going to do that. And I'm going to do it as soon as I can. I don't know what the best time of year to get out there. It might be now because it is summer and they live in, I believe, Illinois. So that's what's up with that. All right, guys, listen, if you were here for the video, I want to say thank you so much. I want to reach out to Aaron Evans this tonight or tomorrow, and I'm gonna see if I can get him to do a show either Friday, probably Friday night show. So be on the lookout for that. I'm also gonna reach back out to John Anthony. We did a great video a few weeks ago. I think you guys have more stuff you want to hear from him. I think it'd be great to talk to him again. So we're gonna be doing more of these live streams. And I'm going to keep working, right? Like I said, I'm trying to get these videos, get this channel pumping back up the way it was back in 2019. All right, guys. Peace. Talk to y'all in a little bit.